Hey guys, what's up? This is Racer53 from the RC Tech Forums here on how to properly build and brake in a ball differential and slip and clutch. The purpose of this video is to give instructions on how to properly build and brake in a ball differential and slip and clutch for a team associated RC10 B4, T4, or SC10. These instructions will also work for any 10th scale ball diff or slip and clutch. I do not claim to be an expert in RC or claim to know everything about our hobby, but there has been a great deal of confusion about this topic with all of the new racers entering 10th scale racing. This article is meant to clear up some of the confusion and make it an easier and more enjoyable process. There are as many different opinions on this topic as there are racers. This is just mine. As you can see, I've already disassembled the back end of the buggy and have the diff separated. I've cleaned all of the old diff lube and black grease off with motor cleaner spray. I like to use Magnum Force 2 by Dynamite. Works great. You can use denatured alcohol as well, but all of the old lube is cleaned off. I'm going to be replacing the diff rings, the differential balls, the thrust bearings, which includes the thrust washers and the thrust balls today. I'm going to be using one of BFast Pro driver kits for a T4. I'm using the one with carbide diff balls and ceramic thrust balls. So I'm going to start out by applying a small bit of lube. I'm using Team Associated Stiff Lube. This is pretty much the best stuff you can get for a differential. I'm now going to apply just a little to this rim on the diff out drive. This is mainly just to get the diff ring to stick. You don't want too much here. I'm just applying a light coating. BFast has very good instructions for their kits. They also come with pretty neat little stickers too. Anyway, vanity. Got diff balls, thrust washers, and we have the diff rings here. Now, most of the time, I like to sand my diff rings. These are supposed to be pretty flat, and I can't see any flaws in them right now. But I'm still going to sand them just to demonstrate this process. I like to use one of these 3M double stick pads. You can get anywhere. It's the perfect size for the diff ring. Stick it on there. Then take some 400 grit sandpaper. I'm going to sand in a circular motion. Just going back and forth. This is just to get any uneven spots and to make it a little less smooth on the diff ring. Otherwise your diff can slip. You only need to sand the side facing the diff balls. However, sanding both sides does no harm. The point of this is most diff rings come too polished and can cause the diff to slip because the balls have nothing to grab onto. Many diff rings also have minor imperfections and are not completely flat. Sanding fixes both of these problems. Now I don't need to do too much to these. They were already in excellent condition. Some would claim I don't have to do any at all, but I'm going to just play it safe. This is 400 grit sandpaper. You don't want to use anything too fine or too gritty. I like 400, some people like 600 or 800. It's more of a personal preference. You want to make sure you work in something like this plastic lid I have, or a white towel, so none of your parts go all over the place and it keeps free of debris. Now also, before this process, you want to make sure if you're reusing any parts, you check them. If you're reusing diff rings, you want to make sure that there's no ridge that the diff balls have created. You can do that by looking at them visually or using your fingernail. You also want to check the diff gear. Make sure there's no chipped teeth or wear. This one was fine. This is pretty much a new kit. You want to make sure nothing's broken, everything's here. If you're using a new thrust spring, you're going to want to compress that with some pliers. This one has already been compressed. Alright, I'm going to clean off the two diff rings that I just sanded with motor cleaner spray in case there's for the dust that I just created. Motor cleaner spray is great, it works, cleans almost just anything off, leaves no residue. Okay, we've got that. I'm going to get the differential balls out. Now again, these are carbide diff balls. I like carbide diff balls better than ceramic diff balls. Ceramic diff balls for the diff are just too hard. They tend to cause the diff to slip too much. You can't set it properly. So I prefer carbide for the diff balls. Now I do like ceramic for the thrust bearing assembly because they need to be hard and stay round and flat, or not flat, so they don't flatten. And that'll keep the thrust bearing nice and smooth. Alright, now I have already applied associated diff lube to the outdrive lips. I'm going to put on the diff rings, both sides. And make sure the side you sanded is facing up. It's going to be where the diff balls are riding on. Alright, now I need to get my bearings for my differential. I'm going to slide those where they go. I've already cleaned and oiled these, so they're ready to go. Now I'm going to put diff lube on top of this. I've already applied it underneath. I need to put it on top where the diff balls will be riding. Be generous with it at this amount, at this time. You want to get a nice amount on there. Mix it in. Make sure if it hasn't already come up through the holes, you want to get diff lube in the holes. Now I'm going to take my diff balls and place them in the holes in the diff gear. I'm going to use my hex driver with just a little bit of lube on it so the balls stick. Some people like to use a magnetized screwdriver. Either way, I don't care. Looks like a magnetized screwdriver would have worked better here. One of my hex drivers is magnetized. Let me see if I can find that one. Apparently none of them are. Alright, well, I'm just going to stick them in the holes. I want to make sure your hands are clean if you're doing it this way. You don't want to get any grit or debris in the holes or on the balls at this point. I've heard good things about BFast diffs, so I'm giving them a try. I haven't tried them before. I'll tell you how it comes out. They're supposed to be some of the smoothest diffs you can buy. Of course, their motto, feel the diff. Stubborn ball. Does not want to go in there. Now, before I dumped my diff balls out on this area, I put a little bit of diff lube here and mixed it around so they have a little bit of a coating on them already. Also so they don't fly all over the place. Some of them are still trying to though. Alright, now I've got them seated in the holes. They're not pressed down all the way. I'm just gonna pick the diff gear up, flip it over, push it down, so now they're all coming up through. Alright, now we need to take a look at the thrust bearing assembly. So I'm going to get my thrust washers and thrust balls out. Little bag is not cooperating. There we go. Nice mirror finish on the